I've been working a lot with the forged carbon fiber fabric from UltiCarbon, so I'm going to go into a bit more detail on the versions available for this and what type of results that you can get. So there's two kinds. You've got the premium bold, which is what I've been using, and then there's also the standard finish, which I've got a piece of here I'm going to test out. So the fabric is convenient in that you can just cut it to size and then you just remove that plastic backing before you place it into your mold or whatever project that you're doing. I put this onto a sheet and vacuum infused it to see what sort of results I would get there. And I backed that with some twill fabric. You can just use it as a surfacing finish and then add whatever fabric at the back for added strength and bulk. Or you could just add more forged at the back. I removed that piece from the sheet and trimmed up the edges. So this is what the standard finish looks like when it's vacuum infused. Of course, the back is bondable, and then on the front I've got this gloss forged carbon fiber look. The pattern comes out quite defined using the vacuum infusion process because the fibers don't really shift around. So I did the same thing with a piece of the premium bold to compare the results. And you can see that there's a distinct difference when using vacuum infusion. The patterns do stay defined, so you get pretty much the same distinction between the standard finish and premium bold once it's infused versus just the raw fabric. They both look quite different. Now for the mask, I used the premium bold and I added several relief cuts to get that to fit into the complex mold. And that came out great. I didn't notice the seam lines at all in the finished product. So to test the limits of that capability, I took the scraps from that and just pieced them together onto a plate. Just did a hand layup with some resin and some scraps of twill backing. I rolled that out to get out as many air bubbles as possible and vacuum bagged the whole thing. So that keeps it all compressed and helps to reduce any air pockets and excess resin. Once the piece was cured, I removed it from the plate, washed off some PVA residue, and trimmed up those edges. And this is what I ended up with. So it looks very nice. It is a lot of different pieces in a small area, and I don't see noticeable seams here. It all just blends into the pattern. So this is definitely something that can be useful for making complex shapes because you can piece it together as needed, and then you can also just use up any smaller pieces on other projects, and the pattern just fits together seamlessly. I also have a couple of the UltiCarbon cured plates. This is a standard finish and a premium bold. These sheets have the forged carbon fiber surface, and then the thickness is built up with layers of twill, but the pattern here isn't as defined as it was with my little vacuum-infused samples, so it definitely matters how you finish the product as to the exact cosmetic result that you're going to get. When you go back to the raw fabric or my little infused pieces here, there's a definite difference between the standard versus the premium bold, but here they look pretty similar. Just a little bit of a larger scale in the pattern on the premium bold. So depending on what sort of finish you want, that's something to take into account as to which of the finishes you need and what process might give you the result that's needed, especially if you're trying to match this to an existing part. I like the fabric because I have the most options there. It's convenient being able to just cut a piece off of the fabric, put it in the mold, piece it together as needed, and not have to worry about the seam lines and get a good finish every time, you know, assuming that everything else is done properly. So I will be using this on more projects in future and cover in more detail any of the techniques that might be useful for getting the best result using this fabric.